Everybody, please turn your microphone. Turn off your microphone, everybody, please. Okay. Okay. Anupam, okay. Yankee, okay. Okay. So we will take 5 minutes, okay, to start. Let everybody join the session. Yes, very good. Yes, Rituparna. Yes, Anupam. Yes, Poppy. Poppy, you are from Bogaigaon. Yes. Yes, Yankee. Yes, Priyatsa, okay, I remember, Madam, Refrena, Refrena, okay, then Sakshi, Suzanne, oh, Suzanne, you were here, I was expecting you, okay, message, yeah, hello, hello, Suzanne, I was expecting you, I think some of the best candidates among you are among them. Sanjeev, okay. Sanjeev, Pratismita, okay, Sanjeev, hi. Okay, Fancy, Partha. We'll take some few minutes, so that means everybody is in the session, then we'll start so that nobody misses the thing. And we will basically what we'll do, first we'll start the session, we will take the session, then I have some announcement to make, I will make the announcement, and then at last I will take all the queries that you have. Okay. So any query you have, be ready with that, because after the session this will be means now we have got around 55 minutes, so we will be spending 30 minutes on our means on Sukhapa, then we will spend fi another 15 10 minutes on the announcement, or 5 to 6 minutes, then we will take up the queries, all the queries that you have, so be ready with your queries. Okay. So after the sessions are over, you may send through a message, or you may make your microphone on your microphone, and you can directly ask the questions. Okay. So I will try to as best as I can, I will try to reply your queries. Okay. More people are coming. Okay. So let's wait 2-3 seconds, 2-3 minutes. Okay, Rituparna. Good evening. Good evening, Rituparna. Okay. Very good. So in the meantime, if power or something problem is there, don't go. I mean, be sure that I'm here, okay, and you'll be able to link up again, okay? through the same link. Okay, welcome, Nikki. Nikki Ojha, okay, welcome. Sanjeev Kumar Boro, welcome, Sanjeev. Utlanta, okay, welcome. Long time we have not seen. So how your studies are going on? Okay. Okay. Fine, fine, Anupam Dutta, fine, okay. Very good, very good. Very good. So, let's start, huh? Dear friends, can we start? Okay, so let's start. So today, since it is the first session, so I thought of starting with the topic of Sukhapa. Why I thought of starting the topic with Sukhapa? Because the very existence of our state or the entire identity of our state is based on what Sukhapa did. Okay, and it is not that 600 years of rule of Ahom is the longest rule in Assam. Even before that, there were further more longer rule. For example, yes, please. Okay. So no more messaging, please. Okay. So dear, no more messaging. Just try to listen, and if you are late, I will just admit you. Okay, dears. Okay, dear. Okay. Okay. No more messaging, please. Okay. So let's start. So why I wanted to talk about Sukhapa is because our identity is related with him, or we can say the foundation of that has been put by Sukhapa. That's why I thought of starting the session with Sukhapa. So I thought of starting the session with Sukhapa, and that's the most important reason. Apart from this, he had made many great contributions that we will see. Because see, within 600 years, the Ahom rule or the Thai Sen tribe were able to give a different identity to, or different set of government, different set of culture, different set of religion. Means they were able to carve out a separate thing for themselves, which was very distinctive, or which we need to be proud of. Whereas even before Ahom rule, there was more longer rule. For example, the Bodo people were very immense. They were there in rule for longer period as per Edwards Gett. He said that Bodo people were there for longer period, but they were not able to leave that mark on our society as the Ahoms. And all those credit, we can say, goes to the founding father of Ahom rule, or the person who laid the foundation of Ahom kingdom. So first we will try to find out why he is so great and why we need to discuss about him. See, the greatness of a person lies in that at the age of 17, think the number, mind it, at the age of 17 he was able to establish a new kingdom in a very alien or a very hostile type of nature or a very hostile type of land. Because see, the place where Sukhapa came and settled in 1228 was a place bordering Naga hills, and there were lots of Naga tribes were there. Clear? There were lots of Naga tribes were there who were very hostile, and they were in their early stage of civilization, or we can say that till that time they were in their wilderness. They were in their wilderness, so it was very difficult, and at that time, and at the age of 17 years, he was able to establish a kingdom, a separate kingdom of himself. That's why he is such a great person, and we need to talk about him. But before that, let us talk about him, from where he came, what was his date of birth, or from which family did he belong, what was his tribe, and all these things. Let us first know about his origin. So his origin, his family background are shrouded with mystery, because in the Thai Sen Chronicles, there is no mention of Sukhapa. In the Thais and Chronicles, where from means our means writers, Indian writers, Assamese writers have are presuming or they claim that he came from Molang. Molang is a place in Upper Burma. Molang is a place in Upper Burma, or we can say South China. From that place, he came to Assam. It is claimed by Assamese writers, Indian writers, as well as Edward Gates. Clear? But if you go through the Thais and Chronicles, there is no mention of Sukapa. At the same time, Assamese Burangji, Deodhai Burangji, also mentions that Sukapa comes from Maulang, but there are some ambiguity. It is self-contradictory regarding his means parents. Okay, there are two names regarding his father. And other there are also oral traditions are there which says that means he is first he was in a separate hills. Let me tell you. Okay. Yes, please switch off the speaker. Sorry, microphone. Okay. So, according to some of the Indian writers, it is said that Sukapa was means brought up in his maternal uncle's place, okay, or at a place called Mungri Mung, at a place called, wait a minute. It's a very difficult, typical name of means a Thaisen name, so it's very difficult to pronounce as well as remember. Let me tell you. Yes, it is called Mongza Mongzi. It is a Thai word, so it's also difficult to pronounce. So it is a place called Mongza Mongzi where he was brought up at his maternal uncle's place. And according to tradition, it is said that his maternal uncle was not having any son. Okay, and he was brought up as the successor of his maternal uncle. But later on, it was found that his maternal uncle had a miss. Later on, he got a son. Okay, so what happened? The chances of his succession was almost nil. So what happened? Sukapa migrated from his maternal uncle's place to his father's place, native place called Molang. So his native place or his origin is Molang, and from Molang he then migrated towards west, and after crossing the Patkai Hills, he came to or he descended in the Brahmaputra Valley. And it was a very tedious or very difficult migration from Maulang to Brahmaputra Valley because he had to cross the very impenetrable or very difficult the terrain of means crossing over from Burma. You still today it is very difficult. Think about means in 1228. What was the means in 13th century? What type of condition was prevailing at that time? And at that time, he crossed means various mountain ranges, rivers. Okay, he used rafts. Okay, and he crossed over from Burma to Assam. It was very difficult, and not only the terrain, climate was difficult, but he had also to face the hostility of various wildering tribes. The tribes were very wild and hostile, especially the Naga people were in the primitive stage at that time. And they were so primitive that they used to eat the alien people. They were so ferocious or so means wilder. Means if they used to find enemy, they used to kill them, and not just kill them, but they also eat them. They were man-eater at that time. Okay, Paul. So they were man-eater, and he had to encounter all those wandering tribes, difficult terrain, and after crossing and after overcoming all these difficulties, he came and descended in the Brahmaputra Valley. And also Brahmaputra Valley, it was not that means it was free. At Brahmaputra Valley, when Sukhafa came, there were two powerful kingdoms in the east. One was Sutiya Kingdom, other was Kachari Kingdom. So he had to be very cautious and very means he can means वेरी डिप्लोमेटिक. अपर्णा, ओके, वेलकम अपर्णा. सो ही हैव टू बी वेरी डिप्लोमेटिक एंड वेरी मीन्स ही हैव टू एक्ट वेरी स्मार्टली, अदरवाइज इट वुड हैव बीन डिफिकल्ट फॉर हिम. सो वट ही डिड, ही केम, ही डिसेंडेड इन ब्रह्मपुत्र वैली. ओके, सो आफ्टर डिसेंडिंग देयर वट ही डिड, ही एडॉप्टेड टू टाइप ऑफ अप्रोच. फर्स्ट अप्रोच ही ऑलवेज एडॉप्टेड सॉफ्ट वन, दैट वॉज कंसिलियरी, मीन्स कंसिलिएशन विद द ट्राइब्स, कंसिलिएशन विद द लोकल पीपल. ओके, सो बींग बिकमिंग फ्रेंड विद दैम एंड नॉट एक्टिंग एज अ इन्वेडर, विच वॉज कॉन्ट्राडिक्टेड टू द पीपल हु वर कमिंग फ्रॉम द वेस्ट. फ्रॉम देयर वेन सुखापा वॉज कमिंग फ्रॉम द ईस्ट अ होम पीपल, एट द सेम टाइम देर वर सीरीज ऑफ इन्वेजन फ्रॉम द वेस्टर्न साइड ऑल्सो, बट फ्रॉम द वेस्टर्न साइड इट वॉज द टर्को अफगान्स हु वर कमिंग एज अ इन्वेडर, एज अ कंकरर. ओके, एंड दे वर मोर हॉस्टाइल, दे यूज टू मीन्स दे यूज टू क्रिएट डेवस्टेशन, दे यूज टू वेक हैवक ऑन द पीपल. ओके, दे यूज टू किल पीपल, दे यूज टू डू मैस्कर एंड एवरी थिंग रॉन्ग वी कैन प्रिज्यूम ऑफ. ओके, दे यूज टू टेक अवे देयर वीमेन, ग्रेनरी एंड एवरी थिंग, कैटल, एवरी थिंग. ओके, सो दिस वॉज इन कॉन्वीनियंस वेयर एज सुखापा एडॉप्टेड जस्ट अपोजिट. He came, he became friendly with the people, he was helping with them, he was showing very immense lenient towards them. He used to be having, means I will tell you how he used to have a diplomacy of means winning the headmans of various tribes. Okay, I will just tell you, but before that let me tell you, when he came here, he first encountered, means when he descended in the Brahmaputra valley, he first chose a place, means after means searching various places, he came to a safe zone near Soraido, and there he established his headquarters, because Soraido is an upland and that land is free from flood. So he selected Soraido as his headquarters, and there he established his small kingdom. That was a very small kingdom between two rivers, one is Dikko and other is Dichang. Okay, between these two rivers he established his kingdom, a small kingdom, by winning over the two local tribes, Barais and Morans. These Barais and Morans were two small tribes, they were not so powerful, small in number. So through his conciliation approach, he took them into confidence. He used to organize feast, he used to call the headmen, and this is how he was able to win these two tribes. And with these two tribes he settled in that region. He settled in the means between the in near Soraido, keeping headquarters and Soraido as its headquarters, he settled between Dikko and Diksen River. Okay, so this was his first small kingdom that was established by Sukhafa. After that, means after establishing the headquarters and after establishing the kingdom, what he did is not that occupying the entire territory. Okay, he did not disturb the local Barahis or Morans. He did not took over their means cultivating lands. He did not even means try to ask means tributes from them also initially. He didn't try to do all these things. Instead, he used to means call them for party, he used to dine with them, he used to even offer them drinks, he used to conduct sacrifices of horses. Big means horse sacrifice was a very big means festival at that time, and he used to do horse sacrifice and call them for dining with them. Okay, one such sacrifice he did when he first established permanent settlement at permanent settlement at which he established his permanent settlement at Soraido as its headquarters, he gave sacrifice of two horses, and in that festival, he